dollars much. Class 10, as already I have shared you the photograph of this of these question papers in your class group also, and it is also being shared on the screen, so I hope that everything is visible to you clearly. So for this, I think Section C literature, some of the part is little bit invisible, or it is cut in the photograph. I'm speaking it, okay? So let us have the discussion of these, you can say, two questions. So now, the first question is Section C literature we are going to discuss. Okay? Now read the given extract or attempt questions. Extract is, but in the hearts of all who lived in that solitary house, in the middle of the valley, there was a single hope and help from God. Don't be so upset. Even though this seems like a total loss, remember, no one dies of hunger. Now here, Lencho's family needed help from what?
Be
God.
God, right. Who lived in the solitary house?
All of these.
All of these, because
All of these.
Lencho along with his wife and his sons. So all of the, these is the right answer here. Next afterwards, we are having, remember, no one dies of hunger. Who said this? God, Postmaster Lencho, Lencho's wife. Lencho's wife. So I know that are the direct questions or the easier ones you will easily be able to answer, but there are some questions in which you will feel problematic. Next question is, Lancho needed help because
The crop was destroyed.
crop was destroyed. Right. Right answer. You can take it down and can analyze yourself side by side. What is the meaning of upset? Now give me one answer. What is the tonic of upset? Yes. What is the tonic of upset?
Ma'am, please speak the options.
It isn't, is not so tough. Like first is given low, shocked. No, shocked is not. Confused. Upset. Upset means not in order. So what do you think? Give your try, let me tell you whether it is right or wrong. Which option, if you are there, please choose.
No.
Is, no, calm. Upset is calm. Calm is the right answer. This is, of course, an unsolved sample paper. You won't get the answers. So now, next one. The next extract is, everything was going well. It was an easy flight. Paris was about 150 kilometers behind me. Please read it carefully. Okay? Because the answers are not so direct. When I saw the clouds, storm clouds, they were huge. They looked like black mountains standing in front of me across the sky. I knew I could not fly up, and over them, I did not have enough fuel to fly around them to the north or south. I ought to go back to Paris, I thought. But I wanted to get home. I wanted the breakfast. I'll take the risk, I thought. Flew that old Dakota straight into the storm. So the first question is, based on given extract, choose the option that lists the name which would be the most appropriate response to. Dash was an, it was an easy flight in the context of the lesson. Out of the picture, which picture you will select? First is you got this. It's almost too easy. The end is here and next one. List the name which would must be most appropriate response to. So which option you would have chosen? Yes. Which option could be which you have chosen? Now give me the answer. Are you able to read this C part? It is you spoke too soon.
Mom, what is written on the picture?
You spoke too soon.
I think A option.
What will be the response of it was an easy flight?
An A option.
I think that in this case, yes, what do you want to say?
Ma'am, I think it is your option.
What would be the most appropriate response to?
Ma'am, A option.
Which one?
A.
A? You got this? It was an easy flight. Second is almost too easy. It was an easy flight. Third is, you spoke too soon. No. Next is, the end is near. It was an easy flight. Very contradictory. Last one. So this can't be the answer. So, E option is the right answer here. I think so, because it's almost too easy. Okay. It was an easy flight. Okay.
Ma'am, can you please explain C option?
Which one?
C.
C option. You spoke too soon. It's written there. I have magnified
what
it.
What this mean?
You spoke too soon. Okay. So the next one is, means tricky question was that. How would you describe the risk the narrator took? What kind of risk it was? Calculated? Impetuous? Unavoidable, or it was navigable. So for the meanings, calculated, you know what is the meaning. Unavoidable, you know what is the meaning. Navigable means which one can navigate. Yes, this can happen, this can happen. Or next was impetuous, which means which is done quickly without any thought. So it means in order to attempt this question, you should know the meanings of all. So what kind of risk it was? What kind of risk the narrator took? It was calculated, unavoidable, impetuous, or navigable. What is your choice? Yes. Krishna, remain unmuted. Yes. What kind of risk is involved? What is your choice? Suppose this question is there in front of you in board exam. Which option you would have chosen? Then we will analyze what is the right answer. Yes.
C option.
Huh?
C.
C. Unavoidable. See the paragraph first of all. Everything was going well. It was an easy flight. Paris was about 150. Kilometers behind me when I saw the clouds. Storm clouds, they were huge. They looked like black mountains. I could fly up and over them. And I did not have enough fuel to fly around them to the north or south. I ought to go back to Paris. But I thought, I wanted to get home. I wanted the breakfast. I'll take the risk, I thought, and flew that old Dakota straight into the storm. Calculated, it was not. He haven't calculated much. Unavoidable? No, you can say. Navigable? No. Impetuous? I think impetuous is the right answer, because this was done quickly. Without any thought. But he has thought. Because unavoidable right answer is the unavoidable. Yes, unavoidable is the right answer here. Because he did not have
any
people to go back.
Excuse me, ma'am. Ma'am, but जो ये risk है वो avoid कर सकता था.
How?
So unavoidable.
How he can be?
Ma'am, वो तो. Ma'am, he could go back, but he took the risk.
He took the risk, but thing is that he did not have enough people to fly around. This is the reason why it was unavoidable. वो कर सकता था if he would have the fuel, but he did not have the fuel. So this is the reason it was unavoidable. At that time, right? If we will say that it is impetuous, means it was done too quickly without any thought. No, he thought over various situations, calculated. He haven't so much calculation. Navigable? No, it was unavoidable because at that time he had no other option. Next,
super option is unavoidable.
The extract has been taken from, naturally the chapter is
Black Aeroplane.
Black Aeroplane, right.
Black Aeroplane.
Next, see the next one. Again, type of question, typical type of question. Read the statements given below and then select the option that best describes the given statements. Now, see what is the nature of statement. First is, narrator's desire to reach home and see his family made him complacent. What is the meaning of now complacent? Anybody knows? And complacent means disapproving. When you are satisfied with things and did not want to change them. So narrator's desire to reach home and see his family made him complacent. So when you are disapproving, you are satisfied with the things. And not wanting to change. Yes, this is somehow true because you can say this is the reason why he was not changing the present situation, though he was in a problem. Next is, narrator was unaware of the thought or unaware of the threat that the adversarial storm clouds presented. He was unaware of that threat.
Can you please share second page?
Yes. He was unaware of the threat. Give me answer in yes or no. Give me an answer in yes or no.
No, ma'am.
Yes.
No, ma'am.
Whether he was unaware of that threat.
No, ma'am. He was aware.
No, ma'am. He was aware about it.
Okay, third is, the narrator's decision making was quick but irresponsible as well as dangerous. Narrator's decision making was quick, but irresponsible as well as dangerous. So when these type of statements, read the option what is given. First option, first of all, you will read. Statement 1 is false, 2 is true, statement 3 cannot be input. It means you should know whether these statements are right and wrong. When you read these kind of statements, just write down whether it is true or false, right? So what we have analyzed? What we have analyzed out of these three statements? Yes. What we have analyzed? So now out of this, what about third statement? Tell me. Narrator's decision making was quick, irresponsible as well as dangerous. True or false?
True.
I'm true.
It means for third statement you are sure. Okay, this is the trick we will use here. First statement, you are sure? Correct me for it. Now come up to first and second statement.
Ma'am, C option.
Right. Okay, let me tell you how she has calculated it. Because first option was statement 1 is false, 2 is true, 3 is cannot be inferred. Wrong option, 3 to worry, 2 hai. And it is only C option, jab aapke only given is that statement. Is true. ऐसे ही है ना? In all the three options, statement 2 cannot be put or 3 is false is written and nowhere it is written 3rd is true. So this is the right answer. C is the correct option. What now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Means when these kind of statements are given, if true and false and not 3rd but are asked, first of all check it out which is true, which is false. Just analyze first of all the question. Then check out for your answer that what you have analyzed is, you can say it is going with the option which you have chosen or not. Then it will make you sure. You must have a logic behind everything. You can say if you have done. Next one is 14th question. Select the correct option to fill the blanks below. Now see here. Risk and risky. Okay. Risk is noun and risky is adjective. Right? Danger and dangerously. Danger is noun, but dangerously is what? Dangerously kya hai?
Adverb.
Hazard and hazardous. Next is peril and imperil. Peril is again, you can say, it is danger. Okay? Peril and imperil. Next, caution and precaution. Caution and precaution, the opposite. So what is going on with the sequence of risk and risky?
Second option.
Second, yes. Hazard and hazard.
B option,
right. Okay, so in this manner, because all the options are almost near to that risky. We cannot pick up odd one out because no one is odd here. Okay, so most appropriate one we have to choose. Next is read the given extract to attempt the questions that follows. He should be lurking in shadows lightly through the long grass near the waterhole where plum deer pass. Okay. So according to this extract, poet wishes for the tiger to be sliding through the foliage. Okay, foliage is the vegetation as this word. Why he would lurk, he would be sliding through the long grass means sliding. Why he should be sliding through the long grass? Why? To assist in keeping the prey unsuspecting of the predator sound. And in uncamouflaging the presence of the predator before it rushes in. Help the predator pounce means jump on the prey comfortably without getting tired. Or support the predator's vision as it eyes its prey. Kya option hoga hai? Which is the right option?
Ma'am, first option.
Assist in keeping the prey unsuspecting of the predator's sound, right? Because second option is also very confusing. Because aapke mind mein, when you will read this extract, immediately the marking that comes to your mind is yes, he was hiding behind it so that his prey would not see it. Right? But the trick used in second option is that he has used not camouflage. Camouflage means to hide, to make yourself, you can say, mix up with the surrounding. But here it is unmixing. Opposite, okay, na? So this is the reason why second option is wrong. A is the right answer. Which fact does not connect with the significance of the water hole of the tiger? Now, which fact does not connect significance of water hole for the tiger? What is the significance of water hole for tiger? See, many tigers chase prey into water and holds victim's head under water until it drowns. Or prey feed in the water on water lilies and often wander into the middle of the water hole where they are vulnerable and easy for the tiger to kill. A prey that has quenched thirst ensures consumption of hydrated meat for the tiger. Or chasing the panicked prey from shallow to deep water where the tiger grabs it. What can be the right answer?
Ma'am, first option.
First, many tigers chase prey into deep water and snow. You can't say that it is not wrong. No.
Ma'am, B option.
Because it was deer. Deer is herbivorous. It could feed on lilies and it could bend down, forgetting about the impending danger. And tiger would have an easy grab over it. बी ऑप्शन. नेक्स्ट इज पिक द ऑप्शन दैट डज नॉट यूज लर्किंग करेक्टली टू फिल द ब्लैंक. व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ लर्किंग?
हाइडिंग.
हाइडिंग. ओके इट्स हाइडिंग. ओके इट्स मीनिंग यू आर नॉट रिमेनिंग नोटिसेबल. ओके The topmost dash in the alley lay cheaply for unsuspecting passerby. Hinermost dash which then after a good meal. Detective cautioned her team about the dash dangers likely to impact the case. But the prejudices dash beneath the surface create misunderstandings. What do you think is the right answer?
Ma'am, B option.
Ma'am, second option. Second option.
Hiner was lurking in his tent after no.
Ma'am, B option, fourth.
No. It is C option. Detective cautioned her team about the lurking dangers. Lurking means that remain unnoticed. Seems unnoticed. C option is the right answer here. Next.
Ma'am, उन्होंने क्या? That does not use.
Does not use. Okay, does not use. Sorry. You are right.
Then it's D option, I think.
It is D option, right. D option is the right answer. Right. You are right. D option is the right answer. So now next one is shallow. Here refers to the shadow of what? Sorry, shadow. Here refers to the shadow of what? Tiger, long grass, waterfall, or deer? What does shadows symbolize? Lurking in shadow. Tiger, waterfall, deer, or long grass?
B option.
Which one?
B, second option.
Yes, long grass, right. Next is pick the phrase that does not suggest that falls in the extract is last, but in the story. What does not suggest? Long grass, yes. Long tears, yes. Lurking in shadow, yes. Only the answer is what? Okay.
Ma'am, B option, the water hole.
Oh, right. Next extract, short time is left. Let me complete it. As they gazed, a remarkable sight met their eyes. A fresh footmark appeared from nowhere. Further footprints followed, one after another, descending the steps and progressing down the street. Who are they? They are people, scientists, boys, or none of these?
Ma'am, two boys.
Two boys, right. Very good. The extract has been taken from what?
Food.
Nothing, no. No option is there. Please. Making of scientists, mini hack driver, mini or question of trust, mini. Who is the author?
Robert.
It's Robert Arthur. Arthur's complete name is not given. Arthur Conan Doyle. Okay. Next synonym. The word progressing means
continuing.
Continuing. Right. Then antonym. Opposite of remarkable is
outstanding.
No, outstanding is again different. Wonderful again different. Phenomenal is again different. Usual. Okay. Next, what did Lancho compare the large raindrops with? What he compared these large raindrops with?
Pearls.
Pearls?
No, ma'am, new coins.
New coins. Man, Raghav, just a moment, please. Man who takes away another man's freedom is white, prisoner of hatred, criminal, or rude?
Criminal?
Prisoner of hatred, right. Next, what was the name of the aeroplane that pilot was flying? It was already given in previous stanza. It was Dakota. No doubt in that. How did Anne justify her being talkative in the essay? She has inherited trait from her mother. Okay, Griffin finally escaped by holding, jumping over, running fast, or taking off his clothes.
Taking off his
Very much right. It is. Next is, what could end the earth? Fire, ice, both are equally competent, or none of the above?
Both are equally
competent, right? This is the right answer here. Next is, what describes tiger in a jungle? Bearing his white fangs, ignoring visitors, strength behind bars, or all of the above?
Above.
Okay, above. All of the above. Oh, right. The ball poem is about boy, girl, cricket player, or mother of the boy?
A boy.
What did Mrs. Pumphrey cut down on? Did Mrs. Pumphrey cut down on sweets as was advised? Yes, no, only for a while, or she was not advised anything?
Yes, she was advised.
Nini, question is, did she cut on sweets? No, she did not cut on sweets. This is the reason why Ricky has fallen ill. No. What was the Anil's age? 15, 25, 20, or none of the above?
20.
You are confused, I know, in 15 and 25, and you will do it yourself. Okay. So now that's all for discussion of the sample paper. Tomorrow again, we will have next set of questions. As you have told me, ma'am, we will have comprehension. I will bring in photocopies, okay, for this type of comprehension. I will try to send it in class group also. It's better that if you can take those printouts. Okay, so today I'm going to send it, get the printouts to be solved in the class, right? And then we will continue with this type of exercises furthermore in the coming days also.